fiscal planning should be taken seriously, because if we don't do it, we are heading for disaster like some other countries. We shall have slums all over the place because it is not a clear-cut profession.
Poor fiscal planning has been highlighted as the major problem facing Kampala City, with slums mushrooming in every suburb. Now, government has moved the Physical Planners Registration Bill 2021 as a solution to physical planning in Uganda.
But at least we should make it very clear that who is a physical planner, who is an architect, who is a surveyor. We are now looking at macro level.
There has not been any legal framework regulating physical planners in Uganda, unlike other professions, which makes it difficult to identify the qualified physical planners from the quacks who administer poor plans. Today, the Minister of Lands, Judith Nabakoba, appeared before the Parliamentary Committee on Physical Infrastructure and justified the bill.
As a country, we need to be serious on matters of physical planning. That's why we are trying to have laws that regulate the conduct, the practice, but also for members to know that at least they are accountable when things go wrong, and probably where to run to when they need help, when they have complaints.
The bill seeks to establish a board as a regulatory body for the physical planners, which will issue and revoke practicing certificates for physical planners. However, the committee is stuck with a conflict in the law to determine whether the architects can be recognized as physical planners in the law.
When we pass this physical planner registration bill, when we are, I think, excluding them, meaning the architects have been completely eroded out of business.
What does an architect understand of a national physical development plan, of regional physical development plans, of district physical development plans? They will understand when you get to neighborhood plans. That's when we start meeting.
MPs on the Physical Infrastructure Committee have asked the Ministry of Lands to consider more deterrent penalties against errant physical planners instead of a 48 current points fine, which is in the law.
Falsely pretends to be a physical planner. That one is very clear. Falsely, you pretend that you're a physical planner. You commit an offence and liable on conviction to a fine not exceeding 48 current points, or imprisonment not exceeding 2 years, or both.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.